The year is 1994, Utah. Terry and Gwen Sherman purchase a ranch in the countryside. At first, things seem relatively normal, but the longer they stay, the more odd things they notice. At first, the disturbances are small. Strange sounds in the middle of the night. Odd trees that look like their branches had been cut off. A strange persisting chemical smell around a batch of bushes. On their own, seemingly just harmless coincidences, but they would soon culminate into something much bigger. At night, the family begins seeing glowing lights in the sky, and later, even just straight up identifies UFOs hovering over their cattle. They wake up at midnight to hear voices speaking languages they don't understand. 7 of their cows die or go missing with odd details present, such as missing very specific body parts. It's safe to say the family is terrified. And yet, their most harrowing encounter is still to come. One evening, about 18 months after they had moved in, Terry is walking their dogs around the property when he comes across a wolf. But this isn't a regular wolf. It is huge, deformed with orange blazing eyes. Terry fires at him, and even though the bullets seemingly have no physical effect, they at least scare the creature off. Unsurprisingly, the Sherman family sold the ranch soon after. Following this incident, the place was purchased by paranormal investigators with the goal of understanding what the family was experiencing. Over the next few years, they have amassed over 100 incidents, including sightings of humanoid figures in trees, reports of weird skin diseases, and unexplained headaches. This was the history of the Skinwalker Ranch, a place named after the Native American legend, which also happens to be the topic of today's video. I'll tell you everything we know about these entities, including appearance, creation, and powers, so you know what to look out for next time you're taking a hike in the woods. So without any further ado, cuddle up to your pets, prepare your magic wands, and let's go. Now to get us started, just as with the Wendigo lore, I have to mention that due to the nature of this legend, different interpretations and retellings give us skinwalkers with varied appearances, processes through which they are created, as well as abilities, so for many of these, I will simply be mentioning all of the most common interpretations. On the surface level, they come from centuries-old Navajo legends, where they are depicted as shape-shifting entities, or sometimes a harmful witch. The original word for skinwalker, which I won't even try to pronounce, has been translated as meaning, by means of it, it goes on all fours, and it is often perceived as a bad omen to even mention it out loud, which is why the natives don't like discussing the topic with outsiders. This has, of course, led to most of the legend being shrouded in mystery, but there are at least a few things which we have come to learn. Originally, skinwalkers were thought to be medicine men who would use their concoctions for evil or malevolent rituals and practices. However, technically, any man, woman, or child could become one if they simply commit something significantly evil. As skinwalkers, they would become deformed and feral, all leading to them developing their signature ability to turn into or possess either a wild animal or sometimes even a person. This creature would then be much larger than its natural counterpart, often possessing huge fangs and claws, together with unmistakably orange/red blazing eyes. These entities would live out in the wilderness, in deep forests or caverns, waiting for potential prey. It is unknown how much intelligence they keep after transforming, or whether they simply become completely wild, like the animals they're embodying, but what is known is that killing them is almost impossible, unless one happens to have a bullet or a knife dipped in white ash. Now sadly, this is where the story pretty much trails off, Because the natives are so reluctant to talk about the topic, we don't know many specifics, tales of encounters, or other characteristics of the skinwalkers. To be completely fair, as time and technology have progressed, less and less people seem to believe in the legend, and currently, even the children who would most often be passing these stories along seem to just substitute other, more commonly referenced monsters into their tales. But hey, I suppose at the end of the day, if you're ever planning to take a hike in the American Southwest, and you happen to have some white ash in your cupboard, well, maybe just take it with you, because you never know what you might run into. But that brings us to the end of the video, so I hope you guys enjoyed and have learned something new about the terrifying entities that maybe inhabit the world around us. If you guys have other entities that you would like me to cover, please make sure to mention them down in the comments below. This, for example, was also a suggested video by you guys, so trust me, I am reading those comments. If you liked the video, maybe consider leaving a like or subscribing. Both of those would be very much appreciated. And with that, I'm gonna see you all in whatever next video I make. Bye-bye.